In this video, I'm going to show you how to assess regional and segmental intervertebral motions of the lumbar spine in flexion in sidelying position. Get our very own assessment ebook and mobile app. Links are in the video description. Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. Passive assessment of the quantity and quality of segmental intervertebral motion, also known as motion palpation, is part of the diagnostic clinical expertise of manual practitioners to guide decisions on a therapeutic strategy for patients with spinal pain. Hypomobility indicates mobilizing interventions, while hypermobility calls for a stabilizing approach. A systematic review done by van Treifel et al. In the year 2005 evaluated the reliability of passive segmental assessment of the lumbar spine and found an overall reliability of poor to fair. For this reason, the clinical value of passive lumbar spine assessment is weak. In order to perform regional range of motion assessment for lumbar flexion of vertebrae T10 till S1 in sidelying, have your patient lie on a side that is about to be examined with his body facing towards you and close to the edge of the bench. The bench height should be adjusted so that you are able to carry your patient's knees on your lap with your patient's hips in 90 degrees of flexion. Your patient holds onto his wrist of the upper arm and perform slight adduction. With your other hand, palpate spinal level until which you want to examine, in our case T10, and rotate your patient's body away until you feel that T10 starts to move. Then slip your other hand under your patient's iliac crest. Now perform a maximal homonymous 3D movement with equal components of flexion, ipsilateral, lateral flexion, and ipsilateral rotation. It's important to maintain the rotation from above by exerting pressure with your forearm in order to stabilize your fixation. This movement causes maximal opening of the facet joints on the side on which the patient is lying on. The whole movement is judged on resistance during motion and at end range of motion, as well as possible pain provocation compared to the other side. In order to continue with segmental assessment of, say, L3, L4, palpate spinous process of L4 and rotate your patient's spine away again until L4 is starting to move. The rotating hand is now moved to L3, while the other hand is slipped under the patient's iliac crest. Now perform a maximal homonymous 3D movement with equal components of flexion, ipsilateral, lateral flexion, and ipsilateral rotation again. Again, make sure to maintain the rotation from above by exerting pressure with your forearm to stabilize your fixation at level L3 while you move from below. To test each component of intervertebral motion, slightly move out of the end range, and now test flexion between L3 and L4 by moving laterally with your body. To assess the rotation component, squat down with your body. And for the lateral flexion component, gently lift your patient's pelvis. Each component is judged on resistance during motion and feel, as well as possible pain provocation compared to the segment above or below. Alright, this was our video on intervertebral motion assessment of lumbar flexion in sidelying. If you want to learn how to assess intervertebral motion of lumbar flexion in sitting position, click on the video right next to me. Thank you very much for watching. Feel free to give this video a like and share it if you liked it. If you want to see more of us, check us out on our other social media channels. And for all of our videos, including articles, statistical values, and more, have a look at our very own assessment ebook and app. Links are in the description down below. This was Kai for Physiotutors. I'll see you next time. Bye.